Hi guys, story time! Today I want to take you on a journey. I want to share some things which I've learned, which I wished I knew before I started bleaching my hair with you guys, so you will know better than I did when you decided to bleach your hair at home. So I started off with virgin hair. My hair is still pretty thick and strong. It was very smooth, it was very straight. I couldn't really style it before that, and this was how I started. So the first time I bleached it, we purchased a box dye, more like a box bleach by Sires. It's a German brand. So I bleached it within one day twice with the same product, so we bought two boxes. And afterwards, my hair was, this kind of piss yellow, brassy tone, and I did not want to walk around with this hair color for a week, and I did not want to bleach it again because the third time would have been very damaging, and by the second time my scalp was already burning and kind of bleeding. So we put a box dye on top of the hair. A few days afterwards we bleached it again, we put another box dye on it, and that was the result. And so I kept that color for quite a while, few weeks. Looking back now, I would have not kept the same color, but back then, you know, it was the first time I bleached my hair, it was the first time I was blonde, so I was like, heck yeah, I'm blonde, man. So here's the first lesson I've learned after this first period, or this first end result. Lesson one, invest into professional products, including the product which you use to maintain the color. So I did buy silver shampoo and silver conditioner from the drugstore, but eventually it did not really help me getting the brassiness from my hair. Okay, coming to the second lesson, I should have known better what color I wanted. Basically back then I just wanted to go blonde. I didn't know really, or I wasn't really aware of the differences of, like, you know, an icy silver blonde, the warm blonde, ashy blonde. Alright, and in the course of the next month after I've bleached it initially, we did some root touch-up with the same box bleach. We did not switch up the product. I did not do enough research, I would say. And we just kept it going. We did the root touch-up, and eventually I noticed that the front of my hair was, like, completely white. It was stripped off of all the colors, and I realized, hey, I like this white color. I don't like the brassy, warm, golden tone. I want to go for the white. And here comes lesson number three, I think. Yeah, that's number three. When you do your root touch-up, please make sure that you don't bleach the part which has been already bleached. We started off with the roots, and then after, when we put the cap on, basically the bleach was on the rest of my hair. So I eventually ended up bleaching my entire hair over and over and over again. I'm lucky that I'm not bald. I'm lucky that I didn't lose my hair. So please make sure that when you do your root touch up, you really only stick to your roots. I eventually did more research, looked at more possibilities to tone your hair, and I found the Vella Color Charm toners. Bleached it again, I did the root touch up with the same box dye, box bleach, and then I put the tone on top, and this is the result right now, and I really, really like the tone, and I want to maintain this color. So in my next videos, I will show you how I will do my root touch-up, because you can see here the color is not very, you know, on the side, it's not nice. So this brings me to lesson number four. Basically, when you bleach your hair, you have to be aware that the bleach is a bleach, and the color is a result out of the bleach and the toner and the dye. And, you know, I was a bit naive, thinking that, okay, put the bleach on and then bam, I'm blonde and it will look good. Wrong, son. You were walking around for months with piss yellow hair and people were laughing at you and you didn't notice because you were like, I'm blonde and it's amazing and I love it. No. So when you guys choose to bleach your hair, be aware that you need to bleach it, and the bleach component is really just to lift the hair color from your natural hair color, and it will create a base for the toner or the dye to work. And basically then you need to do a whole new research on what kind of tone you want to go for, what kind of you know, color you want to go for, and then you have an array of different dyes which are more permanent, and toners which will wash out faster than the dye. Alright, and now to my actual hair color. Here I want to show you the result. You can see the front has this very nice silver white blonde tone. The sides, as I said, bleached it only once, and then I put the toner onto the entire hair. That's why the front is like very nice and the side is still kind of brassy, because I didn't bleach it enough, and obviously the roots were also not bleached to the correct tone or to the level. Alright guys, so in the next videos I will share more information on the entire bleaching process and the products which I've used. Comment down below if you have your own experiences with bleaching your hair, products which you liked and products which you didn't like. Just share with me and the other people watching this video, and hope you enjoyed it, and see you again next time. Bye bye.